Hi everyone, I was a bit unsure what to do this morning, whether to do a pen and wash of an idea. Well, it's not an idea, it's a little place I used to go and paint a while ago, but it's totally different now. Anyway, here we go. As usual, we'll start with the sky, yeah? Okay. Now its wings are blue, that one. Now we'll have to put a little bit of light red in it. And bring some, the same wings are blue on this side, touch it in. Okay, now we'll have it pretty wet. Right. Now I'm going to pick up a little bit of crimson, a little bit of light red. There we are. There's a bit of crimson and a light red. There we are. Now I'm going to strengthen this up a little bit. A little bit of a brighter blue here. Okay. Right. Now let's see. We'll bring up, I'll have a pond here. Now I'm going to go back to our loose painting, which I do love more than anything. Okay. So I'm going to just warm it up a little bit towards this end here, the bottom end, the distant horizon. Weak, with a little bit of light red. Everything will go much lighter, so there, that'll do for us for now. That's okay. Now, you must let this part dry. We'll just bring in a little bit of strength. Just here and there, because it's a little bit weak, so we'll not be afraid of putting a little bit of strength here. Now this is blocking paper. Remember, it goes a lot lighter, doesn't it, you know. Now with this, where you're coming farther down here, if you want, you can add a little bit water around that edge there, but be careful because it starts cauliflowering if you're not careful. Now you can put a little bit of very, very light blue, that's cerulean here, but strangely enough that's not far off, is it? There we are. A little bit of a balance in the clouds from a more natural look. That's it, blending away there. Okay, so we'll leave that just like that. And that's been dried off now, so we'll pick up another brush. And let's see, we'll bring a patch of grass along the front here. So I'm still using that colour what's in the palette, that blue, mixed there with the mix of the burnt. And I put a little bit of raw sienna with that. Just a little bit. And then we'll add our cad yellow. There, there's our green. Make a bit more. Not quite enough there, have we? Windsor. And now that'll be a nice light green. You can add a little bit of raw sienna. There we are. This is raw sienna, picking wrong stuff up. A little bit more raw sienna to give us our dullish green. Dullish warm green, and we'll just bring it across here with a loose sweep. that. Okay, and then we'll add another patch here. And I'll add a little bit of sienna to it. Like so. Okay, we'll leave it at that for a minute. Now then, let's see. Well, it just in this area here. Get some sienna. And let's have some sienna. A little bit of. Just put a little bit of light red and a little bit of lemon yellow, and we'll just see what we get just here. Now let's not a bit grinder, just getting it on loose. Just let me just like so. Just leave it like that for a minute. Okay, now we'll put a little bit of light red with that. And we'll just bring a building out here. Can you just see, I'll just move away for you to see in this area. There. Okay. That building will just come up to there. And we'll have it as a red tile roof. Now that building will have come to there. We'll have another. Yes, that's a, that. Oh, we'll have a small outbuilding. There, like that. And then we'll put a bit of blue to it. And let's see. And we'll have this, another building here. Oh, sideways on. Oh, I love it touching that one. Okay, now I'm going to put some slate roof on. Okay. Yeah, that'll do. See how we're going on now. Another just. Just another building there. Okay, so now a little bit of, just put in just a tiny bit of brass sienna along that there. Like that. I think we'll put the same on this one. A bit stronger than that. And that's okay. And we'll start adding some darks by shaded side, which will be the left hand side, because we'll have the light coming from the right, shall we? forgetting. What would happen to right now, wouldn't we? No, things look a bit rough there, don't they? Okay. They do, don't they? A bit rough. Now let's just think of this bit. I think that will do for us. Things are not very straight, but we'll straighten them up in a bit. Okay, let's have some Windsor, some Cab Yellow, some Burnt Umber. Just a second. That'll do there. A bit of burnt umber in there, a bit of burnt sienna. There we are, sienna in there. Okay. More burnt sienna. Okay. Right. Let's go in. Keeping you out. Okay. Okay. Well, you can see things developing there, can't you? You can see where we're coming from. Okay. There we are. Now coming to it. There we are. Okay, now let's carry on a little bit here. There we are. Now then. There we are, that'll do for now. Right. We'll just have a faint shadow coming over the top. Some umber and cobalt here. Just like that. Okay, let's get this straighter. If I can. Okay, now let's see if I can get some nice smaller stuff in here. Now a bit of that's okay. Nice and dark. That wasn't quite dark enough. sorry about not speaking much, am I? There we are. Now, it is a loose painting, so if you like this, you could copy this, draw it out, and do a better painting of it than I've done. This is just to help you along the way, give you your ideas. Well, that's all I can. I had an idea of doing it in more detail, so I'll let you look at that for a minute or two, and see. Right. Well, I can look at that with this. But don't forget, it is a loose painting. I'm not trying to make it too tight. And as I told, it could have been done with a bit of pen and wash first. So if you look at that for a minute, now that's really loose, very loose, isn't it? So what I'll do now, I'll just stop that for a second, and now you can look at one where I've put the as a canal seam with the old windmill broken, and I've drawn it out with an ordinary black pen, an Eber pen, is it? Let me see what sort of pen it is. Then I can tell you. It's not advertising really. It's a Unipin Fine Line Water and Fade Proof Pigment Ink. Black. It's black. It's Unipin Fine Line. Can't remember where I got it from. Sorry. 0.8, that one. Okay. I'll just stop that a second.